several times a year, thousands and thousands of citizens of this country spend their precious moments preparing for something that will happen only once in their life and never again. Yes, I think you have guessed it right. It is the ceremony known as Geography Unit Test 4. My brother was having a hard time memorizing the capitals of some 13 odd countries. Oh, how I wish I could travel to all those capitals all at once, taking a long PM. Oh no, you first have to study the capitals of these countries, da, then only can you travel. So said the teacher, he said. So he was busy studying and I was watching him. And I commented, "Oh my god, you don't even know the capital of Brazil? Check." And he replied, "Bhaiya, I know the capital of Brazil. I just don't know which country's capital is Rio de Janeiro." You see, you teach a man to fish and he starts selling you old fish, crab fish, tail fish, bull fish, lots of it. Now friends, these are testing times indeed. And may the force be with you when the gravity of the question paper in front of you makes you drop dead in the desk. It is because our siblings, or you should say young friends of us, old and small, young and strong, girls and boys, they are having difficulties in their studies. I once went on a trip to my uncle's place. He had a son, he's in the 10th standard. He was reading an encyclopedia which I had couriered to him long back. He just read out a paragraph, it was a chapter summary. He read, "In this chapter, wide trains and trams are shown exploding in detail with their photographs covered everywhere." Oh, come again? Okay, I'll try to come again as best as I can what he said. "Wide trains and trams are shown exploding in detail with their photos covered everywhere in the book." Wait a minute, is this an encyclopedia, a fact book or a kill book? So, for information, for your wit, I will tell what exactly the chapter summary said. It said, "In this chapter, a wide range of trains and trams are shown in detail. Exploding view photographs are also covered wherever required in the book." You see, the reading level of a 10th standard year old boy is at the 7th standard level. A 6th standard year old girl reads at the 3rd standard year old kid. And a 3rd standard year old kid does not read at all. Oh, you may think that I'm lying. Your niece or maybe your friend's daughter can read well. But no, I have certain facts to prove you wrong. There was a United Nations survey which was conducted in 2015. It's known as the Education for All Report, in which many numbers and statistics are scattered, like gross enrollment ratio, net enrollment ratio, youth literacy rate, adult literacy rate, and they have some figures like 58%, 93%, 90%, 71% respectively. Now this was very well taken by the media. But one thing was overlooked, and that is a survival rate. Okay, now this survival rate is not the infant mortality. This is the students who continue from standard 1 to standard 5. And the survival rate is only 66%. That means a full one-third of the class do not go from 1 standard to 5 standard. This is the fate of our junior batch, our so-called millennial generation. On one hand, the expectations are sky high. On the other, the quality education is subpar. They cannot even meet the basic standards. It also brings to my attention something that I read on the internet. It's known as the diary of a school teacher. Now this, you may or may not find it yourself, and if you're interested, I'll email it to you. There's an excerpt I'd like to quote. "This person is no more with us. He was late village school teacher, Mr. Hemraj Bhatt, who was teaching in a small school, a very small school in the uphills of Uttarakhand. What he found was, the kids of 2nd, 3rd, 4th standard were having a very difficult time reading paragraphs. Now you would say, of course, words, if you know words, you can make sentences, if you can make sentences, you can read paragraphs. But no, that was not the case. So he found a solution of sorts. He divided them into two sections. One section was more better, well versed. That section could match the words that they knew with words that they could find in the picture book and words that they knew in their mother tongue. Using those words, they quickly, over a period of time of course, not as quickly as you and me, glanced what the paragraph was and explained the same, which my cousin could not do, remember? Explain the same to the second section, in the very same section. And thus, he broke the rigidity of the curriculum which wants you to learn alphabet, then the word, then the pronunciation, then the sentence structure and so on till the fifth standard. So because of this, he just outpassed it and people started learning. The reading level of a third standard year old kid came back to where it was. Earlier it was at the first standard or zero, no standard at all. As Toastmasters, you have overcome many gaps. You have cleared many misconceptions, maybe about language, about not general knowledge, about communication. You must have even surpassed or reached the expectations of the corporate world at large. But please remember, let us not forget about the younger brothers and sisters that we have, who are having a difficult time memorizing facts, even when the linkages are clear, who have a difficult time explaining things just right, maybe in the newspapers, etc. I urge every one of you that you can help. You might be having your own kids, maybe the kids of your neighbors, your maids and servants maybe, your siblings, relatives, maybe your relative siblings, your friends. Offer to help. Take an interest in how they learn if you get some time. Because I know most of you are Toastmasters, budding Toastmasters, established Toastmasters. You can help for sure. Related to something previously, in the question paper, if we leave something, we just said, okay, I don't get it, I'll just leave it. But in real life, this can't happen. If you don't get it, you just don't leave it. And that brings to me something that I have always had in mind since my childhood, that is Pokemon. If you want to catch a Pokemon, you go catch a Pokemon. You don't just leave it. You go out there and you catch it. So, like Pokemon, just catch all these people young, catch them all, catch them young, catch these people, catch them all. Thank you.